Hey guys, it's Ethan here with Extreme RC 4x4, and today I have the Axial AR60 OCP full width axle adapter set, and this is what it looks like. This is $65, and you get your aluminum output ends of the axle, I guess. They're normally plastic. And you get some bearings with it. Also, you get longer axle shafts, because what this kit does is, on the Axial Yetis, when you get them, they have a wide hex hub on the rear rims, on their IFD rims that they sell, and on the front end they have this narrow one. So when you get this kit, if you want to have the rear and front widths the same, you're going to have to purchase this also. This is just four of the wide ones and four of the narrow ones, and then you get hex adapters that go on the end right there. So I've already gone ahead and removed the axle from the Axial Yeti. And it was pretty simple, just a little bit extra with the anti-sway bar, and that was it. But before we get started, I just want to say that these pieces right here, you can get the outputs that are the normal length for, I think it was $45. So all you're paying for in this kit is the extra $20 worth of axle shafts and bearings, and then a little bit longer parts. So this retails $65. Not sure what I paid for this, but I got it all from RPV Hobby a while back. And so we're just gonna start off. I haven't even taken this axle apart ever in the time that I've had this truck, so it'll be interesting to see how everything's been holding up. So I've already gone and removed the tires too, and already I can hear interesting noises. So anyways, moving on from that, the first thing I am going to do is to remove the ends of the axles, starting with the hex adapters right here. So that one doesn't want to budge, but the other one already came out. I'm going to go ahead and remove the pin and then get started going on the outsides. So, not exactly sure what's not letting the axle shafts come all the way out yet, but have to see. I believe this is just a one piece axle with the diff cover that comes off. So, alright. So, this is the axle. Just got it open. This is what it looks like from the factory. Looks like you've got this gray type of grease, and then down here you have, this must be what it looks like fresh. Okay, and now even further back, that's what it looks like. If you just remove one of these screws, it'll give clearance for the axle shaft to be able to be removed. Slide right out. The problem is just this little lip right there gets caught. Alright guys, so now we're actually going to be able to get to the product that we have today, and just going to cut this open so we can see what we get. And one thing I did notice is that this comes with instructions. A lot of RC parts don't come with instructions, so that's a nice feature. Alright, here is our new axle housing extenders. So you get it nice teeth in there to make sure these aren't spinning, I guess. They do have axial on them, and then it says axial on the end on one side and the other side. So if you don't really like that, I'm not sure what to do about it, because it is anodized black, and same way with this one. Alright, so here's more parts. What you get is four bearings and then four screws. Your directions here. And then axle shafts are in this bag. So here is the long one, and for comparison we could do so in comparison in length, here's what we have. These are the short ones. The top one with the bearing being the original stock one, and the bottom one being the extended one that comes with the kit. So, pretty significant difference there. And I do notice that these do not have the lip on the end that I was having trouble with getting around certain things. So that might be nice. And alright, so we can take a look at our instructions here. Alright guys, I've gone ahead and figured out how to install this unit on the short side of the axle, and definitely very simple. So I'm just going to give it a quick rundown to show you guys how to do this if you're confused at home. So, first thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna take your grease, and then I just like to stick it in this end down here, just a decent amount, because it has to go down this whole axle shaft here. So, don't be afraid to put too much. And then we're going to take our axle shaft right here, put a small amount of grease on it. This is probably a little bit more than I need for this. And then I'm gonna grab one of the four bearings that comes with the kit and just slide this all the way down until it stops you right there. Wipe around some of that extra grease, and then what you're gonna do is grease the other end of it, grab the other bearing that you have, and then stick that on the side with the threads and push that on until you get to the stop. Set that aside for a second. We're gonna grab this piece here, set aside a second. What I like to do is go around the outside here of where all the teeth are that kind of show the position of your output. I don't even know what to call this thing. So then I'm going to run some along the inside of here, do the same thing along the outside along here. So your axle shaft is going into your axle. It stops right here. Then you're just gonna spin it around, wait for it to find its spot on the locker, and then just push it in. Then what you're gonna do is grab your greased up output piece, and then make sure you watch the holes in your axle housing and the holes in the aluminum. You just want to make sure those line up because of the teeth that's on the axle housing and this, so that they're in the right position. Slide those together, make sure they're all the way together. Now we're going to grab our screwdriver, and then they did supply 4 screws that will secure it to the axle housing. So you take that, make sure you stick it in the right spot again, and just slowly thread it in. Make sure everything is aligned together. And this aluminum is threaded, so make sure you're not stripping out your screws. Okay, so now the sides are completed. Then you're going to take your diff cover, and then just line it up and drop it together. And you will hear it kind of pop together. It has a kind of a tight fit. Now that is done, I'm going to put the sway bar and the lower link mount screw back in, because we had to take that out to remove the axle shaft. Now I'm just going to go over the axle and clean off the outside, because now I am completely done with the greasy part of it, pretty much. Now from here, the only thing left that I have to do is install the hexes onto here. Okay guys, so now we're going to get into the second part that I ordered here. And what I have with me right here are the 2 rear tires. And I have these because the rear tires are on the wide offset. And now you're going to need the narrow. Or if you'd like to run the entire truck at a wider stance, then you'll need to put wider ones on the front, because the front runs the narrow ones. So, just going to start out. You just have to remove the 6 screws securing the hex adapter onto the back of the rim here. With that removed, you have your rim here with no hex adapter. And you're going to grab the narrow one, set it in there, and make sure you align screw holes. Alright, so now that is all you'll have to do. Just install this onto your rear axle, and I'll have to throw my rear axle back onto the truck and reinstall the hexes to the axle. But that is also supplied in the kit. You get your hexes for it, and it also provides you with pins and little set screws. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And please stay tuned, because I am planning on doing a running video of this truck and possibly a review. So thank you for watching, and have a nice day.